to the ItalianCookingClass.com. Hello and welcome. What we're doing today is a lovely salsa aioli. Now, salsa aioli, some people confuse that for a garlic mayonnaise, which it isn't. It is an emulsification of garlic, turning into the consistency of a mayonnaise with egg and oil, though it's not a garlic mayonnaise, because to me a garlic mayonnaise is a mayonnaise. Get some garlic, crush it through and mix it together, and becoming a garlic mayonnaise as such. That's why it's not called garlic mayonnaise and it's called salsa aioli. Aioli meaning garlic. Though what it is the actual base of it is with garlic, of course, and the emulsification starts with the garlic and the egg. Not the egg and the other ingredients as you make a mayonnaise, which is in one of my other videos, if you wanted to go through. I even explain the reason why I use a food processor more so than a whisk, because this can be made exactly the same as a mayonnaise, just with different base ingredients. So traditionally and originally, a aioli was made in a mortar and pestle, and I'm not going there. I tried once and it was quite complex in the sense it took time, and not many people do that. I saw one person ever do that, and it was Mr. Jamie Oliver. I was so impressed by it. I'm sure it was in an outdoor setting, and it might have been a barbecue or an open fire that he was next to cooking up some pork cutlets, and he made a salsa aioli. But he started, he said, this is how you do it, in the mortar and pestle, because you grind the actual garlic in the mortar and pestle with the egg, and you make that emulsification start. Imagine how hard that would be, even harder than with a whisk in a bowl. So with a mortar and pestle, grinding the egg and the garlic together, getting all the spices up, then you start adding the oil to it, slowly, and getting a wonderful thick cream. He said, right, this is what you're doing. Then they stopped the thing and said, I'll be back shortly. And I think it would have taken about an hour and a half, because when he came back on the scene, he was dripping wet of sweat, and he said, this is so hard, but I've done it. And he was dripping wet with the actual work that was required to do it, but he did get it, and it looked beautiful and creamy. And it's, when it is like that too, it's really, really spicy of the garlic coming through. It's lovely and wonderful, and it isn't as thick as what it is when you make it in a mechanical device like a processor. What happens is also it does separate a lot quicker. So we're going to do it in a food processor. But what we have, what are the ingredients for this? It's very simply is egg. I use one whole egg because the egg goes further, it's healthier for you, and it makes it a lighter sauce as well and more creamy, not so dense. Then we have some vegetable oil. I like to use vegetable oil because it's not too thick and it's not too heavy in flavor, and it doesn't adulterate the other flavors. The other flavors come through nicely. A little bit of salt always to bring out the flavor. We've got some water, garlic, and some lemon juice, fresh. And that's all it is for a traditional salsa aioli. So we'll get that happening. What we're going to do now is we're just going to make this aioli up. Again, I've used a whole egg. That's what I'm going to use, because I do find that it makes the sauce lighter in texture as well as flavour, not so dense, and you get a lot more out of it as well. So it also asks for 4 cloves of garlic, and what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to cut them up beforehand. But just before we go, 4 cloves of garlic is actually 4 cloves of garlic, as it says, but how big is a clove of garlic? And obviously there are different sizes in cloves of garlic. Again, it's entirely your own preference. You know, you get an average of what, you know, an average clove of garlic. So they say 4 of those, whatever you like. If you like more garlic, you put more garlic. You like less garlic, you put less garlic in it, and so forth. So, but I'm just gonna cut this up. And the reason why I'm cutting it, just so that it just makes a quicker process to actually combine with the egg in the food processor. So we'll just pop that in there like that. Again, all it is, it's garlic, olive oil, lemon juice, and water. Not olive oil, but olive oil if you like. I'm using vegetable oil. I'll just take that butt off the garlic there. A little bit of salt. Again, the salt always brings out the flavor of the individual ingredients and gives it a lot more flavor. Because if you see, salt is a flavor extractor. It brings out the moisture for inside the ingredient, brings it to the surface, and that's why you get those beautiful flavors. Because it allows all the flavors to amalgamate together as well. I mean, obviously, if you put too much salt, it changes the whole thing. So it's not like an additive. Well, it is an additive, but it's not like a flavor additive. It extracts the flavors of the ingredients. So, okay, so we're gonna do this. We're gonna mulch it up. It's off and away, and it's going. Now, the longer that you actually do this, I'm actually gonna stop that and I'll pulse it because what I find is that because it's going around so fast that sometimes some of the garlic doesn't actually mulch and just sort of sits and spins around in the whole swirl of things. So we'll let it sit and we'll give it a hit, and that way it actually allows it all to break up nicely. Have another look at that. Any lumps in there? There's a couple over there. That's fine, there we go. Let's just undo now. The longer you let this happen, the actual sauce will be a lot thicker. So depending how much you like to get into the egg and the garlic, it will make a difference to the end result. So that's about all I want to do. So I don't want it to be too thick, because again, it'll be quite thick and heavy. So we'll add, and it is important not to add the water or the lemon juice until after you've added the oil, because it'll change the whole complexity of the end result. So we want to add the garlic and the egg first with the salt, and then now we're going to add the oil. You can hear that thickening up now. So it's basically just pouring it in. There's no way that you could do it this fast if you're using a whisk. Now, but what I like to do is get a nice juicy lemon, and we actually pre-juice it and juice it all, get all the juice out of it. That way you're always consistent with the actual end result. I could have that just in half and just squeezed it out, and that's okay as well. Because what it does do, with, you know, that's how much you're using, but then you can always taste it and add as you like, obviously. But if you get all the lemon out, you can actually even weigh it, or you can actually measure the volume of the how much lemon juice you use every time if you like. So I'm going to use the squeezed lemon. That's what I do all the time. I squeeze all the lemon out and use that. It's always about the same, very close. So we'll just pour that straight in. Oh, now it's all just combined. It's a little bit of the edge there. You can actually see that little bit more. But now it's starting to just pour it through and amalgamate nicely. So when it's running in the middle, obviously because the blades there are actually moving faster. But that's a pretty nice even consistency there. The edge is a little bit, yeah, see how they're sticking really, really slowly. It's green, but it is working its way around, and it's all pretty good now. There we go. That's pretty much it. Got the good out, we'll stop that.
We stopped it because the consistency was fine. Now we're going to have a taste. We may need a bit more lemon juice or something. I haven't added the water yet, but I will do as soon as we have a taste of this. Wow. It's all spicy garlic with lemon juice. And beautiful. Smooth creamy oil there, but it's just so strong coming through. It's really nice. It really is nice. And I'm even thinking not to add the water, but what I'll do is I'll add a little bit, because it's always different, you know. That's a beautiful thing about when we connect with the food. You know, you might do the same recipe 1,000 times, you know, and there's always something you can do to it in between times, you know. Or there's times where it's just always the same, you know. It just depends on the day, the emotion, and, you know, how you're feeling. But, you know, it really is beautiful. That's it. It's just like art, you know. You can just play with it any way you like. So we're going to add a little bit of water just to see how we go. That was enough just to make through, and it does make it smoother. It's taken out the spice and allowed that lemon flavour to come through a bit more. So it's mellowed out. It's creamy still. The garlic isn't so prominent. The garlic is, but the spice isn't, and the lemon is balanced out a little bit more. So it's wonderful. Now we'll just pour that in here, and you can see that it will pour just nicely. Wonderful. There we go. The lemon's just lovely. And if you want to actually make it thicker than what it is, because it will separate quicker now if it sits, you just use more oil. But the flavour will change, of course, so bear that in mind. So we'll just give it a taste, and we're going to use a finger this time, excuse me, but it's so much fun. Buonissimo, proprio buonissimo, it is fantastic. The flavour is just so wonderful, and it really just is so rounded. Because of the garlic, of course, and then the spice just hits you at the top of the palate towards the back of your throat. But it is wonderful. And this is Salsa Aioli with the ItalianCookingClass.com. Grazie, arrivederci e buon appetito.